Dr. Hallervorden. I made this game for the 7-day roguelike competition in the year 2018. And I've been making videos of other people's games, but it's time to make one of my game. So let's go. This is the help screen. I'm not going to read it to you. I know what all this stuff does, but basically there's melee combat, there's ranged combat, there's equipment, there's a fatigue mechanic. You know, when you get too tired, you lose a turn. Pretty simple. A year ago, you were kidnapped by Dr. Hallervorden's henchmen. For the past year, you have been subjected to his demented experiments. You are stronger and more capable than when you came in, but nothing remains of your mind except rage. This morning, your cell door swung open on its own. It's time to escape. Current room, a dark, claustrophobic cell. Zero stims, zero health boosts. No equipment. Hit tab, and hey, it's a feral test subject. A test subject just like you, but no longer able to tell friend from foe. And I'm just going to hit enter to just attack this dude. He's dead. Great. I have a rock. I'm going to equip the rock. And then I'm going to rest. Okay, great. So I have no more fatigue. So I'm going to wander around my cell block till I find somebody whose brains I can bash in. Like this guard who has a laser gun. But it's not really hurting me too much. He's dancing away from me a bit, but hey, there we go. I cornered him. And you can see when his bar is yellow, he will stumble from exhaustion every other turn. All right, cool. So I've got his jacket. I've got his laser gun. Picking up items. Another guard. And I'm going to go ahead and clear the level of items just to make sure that I'm full up on stims and stuff. So he's got a baton. Currently I'll do 10 range damage, and this weapon will do 20 physical melee damage. So I'm going to hang on to this gun. It's generally good to keep your ranged weapon until you really need to use a melee weapon. Otherwise, you end up just taking a lot of damage that you don't need to. Always better to fire from a distance. I'm pretty used to doing that move of just dancing around the enemy, backing away, firing, backing away. Because the optimal firing range is one cell between you. As soon as you open the door to the second floor, you're hit with the scent of bodily fluids. For a moment, your mind is overwhelmed by recollections of the times you were carried up here to undergo modifications. It's time to make the doctors pay. Okay. Current room, medical testing. So far, so good. Rabbit cages. Hey, look, a rabbit. Now, as the guy who made this game, I happen to know that anytime you see these three doors next to each other in this horizontal room, It's going to be some kind of animal cage, and there's no experience points, so there's no benefit to you killing those helpless poor animals. So I just avoid them. Evil doctor, kill the evil doctor. Equip my baton because you got within melee distance. Kill the doctor. Okay, now I get a lab coat, which is a little bit better if I remember right. Well, especially since I'm wearing nothing, yeah, let's equip the lab coat. And I need to wield my ranged weapon again. Switch over to a bone saw. The bone saw compared to the baton is actually identical. Oh well. Oh, but the bone saw is heavier. So it's better if I take the baton, drop the bone saw, drop the light jacket, drop the rock. My inventory management is only so-so. You know, you gotta focus on a subset of things when you're doing these kinds of you know, time boxed challenges. So many medicines. Come here, guard. All right, well now I'm already kind of steamrolling everybody. So, but we're not gonna start being careless because that's how you die. Just gonna calmly wander the halls until we find an exit. Yeah, so I've gone from being a little, having to kind of kite the guards around to being able to just walk up and stab them in the face, which is good. Work gloves are better than black leather gloves, I believe. Actually, the leather gloves are, they're just a little better. So let's drop those. Let's drop the, I mean, yeah, I'm gonna end up with all this gear because auto pickup means that I just get everything that's on the floor. So I end up with, like, no matter what I do, I end up with a ton of gear that I probably don't want. You know, it's kind of just what I ended up with. This is the human cages, so if I open one of these, yeah, I'm gonna get one of these dudes wielding a piece of rebar. The piece of rebar was my first melee weapon, and I was like, what are you gonna find? A gas mask. Cool, so now I'm fully armored. The way combat works is it'll choose randomly between which part of your body to hit, and then use that armor to decide how much damage to do. So that way, you know, you can do enemy design where they've got like a really good torso armor, but maybe not so good of a head armor, so you still have a chance of hitting them. And of course, animals are not armored. I've played this game so many times at this point, you know, having been the one to write it. It's just autopiloting myself through here while still trying to be careful. You can really hear my fingers working those arrow keys. I disabled key repeat because the way that the event loop works in the library that I'm using, it'll queue up events and then unleash them all at once, and there's not really a way to tell when that's going on. There's other ways to do it that would have been better, right? Like just maybe if the key is being held down and it's already been like half a second, then move, but you know, whatever. 7 days, right? We do what we can. Okay, a bunch of gear I already have. At this point, if I find the exit, I'm gonna take it because I'm seeing a lot of duplicate gear. You know, despite the variety of items, you still, like the levels are so big that you'll just end up seeing a lot of duplicate stuff. Although maybe I'll just keep going and just see what I can find. Because there are a couple of, you know, not secret areas, but special areas that have extra good gear that you'll only find if you really snoop around. And they need a lot of space to spawn. Was that a technician? Oh, cool, I got a utility knife. That's one of the better weapons. But it's literally, oh yeah, it's the same as the baton, it's just lighter. Okay, great. Let's do a quick gear swap here. So we're gonna drop the baton, we're gonna drop the syringe. Wait, what did I just drop? Did I mean to do that? Baton, bone saw, syringe. Great. Drop, 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 drop. And equip the utility knife. And that's really just gonna sort that stuff to the top because like, hey, I just picked up a bunch of gear I don't need. Great. Thanks, Steve. The fact that guards with ranged weapons will come towards you at all is a bug. But it ends up working out in the player's favor, so I hung on to it. The other fun thing about the system is that if you want to do pathfinding, you have to just keep clicking. You have to click like a bazillion times. Is that really it? I'm not gonna, well, these doors are just gonna have like, you know, nothing behind them. I don't think I missed anything. Oh, it was, no, it is that. Oh, yeah, okay. Well, screw it. Next level. This floor seems to be made of connected spherical pods. You aren't sure what it's for, but angry animal noises echo from every corner. The natural selection complex. This is a monkey. Okay, I killed it. It dropped some poop. Okay, this level is one that spawns the special rooms pretty regularly, so I am going to explore the entire thing. Fortunately, it's not very big. Yeah, so this monkey's throwing poop at me. All right, time to rest up. Oh, that's a beagle. I think I better take a stim, which I have many. All right, rest up. Pig. These can be pretty tough if you're not careful. But I am careful. So, yeah, not too bad. Here we go. All right, chainmail. 10 kilograms, too heavy. Longsword, that's a pretty good weapon. It's all just chainmail around here. Current room, a tiny museum of medieval armor and weaponry. You're not sure why it's here, but some of this stuff looks useful. So yeah, I'm just gonna skip the chainmail. It's just too much. And if somebody shocks me with a taser, I'm just dead. That ding is my text messages. So just, you know, ignore that. The exits are always spawned far away from the player, so it's probably gonna be a while. Okay, now that I have this long sword, that's pretty cool. And a big laser gun, all right. So I basically have my ascension kit now, and it's only level 3, but there's only 5 levels, so I guess that works out. Drop the tiny laser gun, drop the syringe, drop the scalpel, drop the poop. Wait, what did I just drop? Yeah, fine. Drop the scalpel, drop the poop, and we're good to go. We're guaranteed to only have one of each of those rooms spawn in a level, so now we know we can move to the next one. Oh no! You remember how I said I wasn't gonna be stupid? I was stupid. I'm gonna cheat. If you load a game, it'll just load from the start of that level. So let's just do that, because I don't really feel like starting over. If I wanted to, I could just edit this video. But I won't. Because I'm a good person. All right, just gonna explore this again. There's nothing over there. That's fine. No, because the museum was down here. And I just wanted the long sword. And I can get rid of a bunch of stuff. And go find, well, kill the pig. Rest up. Get the big laser gun. Drop the tiny laser gun. All right, and then don't die. Don't be a stupid idiot. Fortunately, we just have a big-ass sword. So yeah, when you tell all your friends about this video, just skip the part where I just cheated and restarted a level. Just let's just not mention that to anybody. Okay, this floor seems more fit for human habitation. The floor is tile and the walls are concrete. Perhaps this is where the henchmen live. Okay, so I've spawned next to a low-level henchman, which we've been just murdering the heck out of before, and a mid-grade henchman, which has, you know, some actual stuff going on. But I'm a badass with a giant sword, wearing a gas mask, a lab coat, and some work gloves, and probably no pants or shoes, because no one in this game wears pants or shoes. And let's just go get all murdery on him. You're dead. Okay, well, I'm just gonna wait here, recover some fatigue. Let's equip my big laser gun. One shot, dead. Yeah, so my approach to balance was pretty much whatever I felt like. They're just, you know, there's at least one weapon in this game which is just, it's just absurdly overpowered, and I just decided that I didn't care, because I feel like the character in this game, you know, this like awoken test subject, just deserves to be able to just mow down his enemies at some point. It's just, I think that he really needs that catharsis. And if that makes the player's job easier, so much the better. Okay, I have a laser-proof jacket. Let's wear that. I have a SWAT helmet. Let's wear that. I have thick rubber gloves, so I'm basically impervious to lasers now. And I also have a giant laser gun, which I will use to kill everyone. And I just feel like that has just got to be okay with people. All right, let's ditch some inventory again. All right, I have a shock baton, which is pretty good. Sometimes you just need that if you want to deal with enemies with low electrical resistance. Ooh, a tactical vest. That's a good one. Let's wield that. Come and get me, coppers. Say hello to my giant laser. Oh yeah, something that it's not mentioned in the manual anywhere, but there really ought to be, is when you are losing a turn to fatigue, your dexterity or your dodge chance is cut in half. So basically you shouldn't run out of stamina, because that's bad for you. You know, this fact may come as a surprise. At some point, I ended up with a taser, which is pretty nice. Shock baton, easy kill. I popped too many enemies at once, so I'm just gonna retreat a little bit. Die. A lot of items in that one spot. Okay, you have a shock baton, I have a shock baton. Let's just see how that goes. Oh, I won. Okay, what a surprise. Alright, get that stamina back. I kind of regret calling it fatigue instead of stamina. It makes a lot more sense. It's a lot easier to say. But, you know, that's what we ended up with. Bunch of stuff I already have. Cool. Yeah, this really is my ascension kit. Like I don't actually need any more items, which is good because the rest of the levels are pretty light on items on purpose. Sounds like I'm pretty much at my inventory limit, which is not a big deal. All right, let's just find the exit and get out of here. The balance is definitely meant to be almost more roleplay than like real balance. One of the things that I was going for was the sense of being in a place. Which which to me means that not everything is always tuned exactly for optimal game design. Right? Like if it's too gamey, I mean obviously like it's a freaking roguelike, right? Like it's about as gamey as it gets, but mitigating that I think can be good. My controller is starting to feel a tiny bit sluggish, which is weird. I mean, maybe it's just because I'm playing on a larger map that's more revealed than the previous ones. You step out into a hot, humid, artificial jungle. Insects and birds flit and chatter around you. It seems peaceful at first, but you think you hear something moving in the bushes. Let's find out what that is. A velociraptor, a raptor clone from DNA trapped in amber with a laser attached to its head. Well, okay, there are now three velociraptors in sight. The optimal strategy for this level is just to beeline for the exit, which is what I was going for. Okay, I only have a 28% chance to hit because their dodge is just amazing. Fortunately, predicting the exit point isn't too difficult because the algorithm is that it will choose a few random points and then take the one that is farthest away. So I'm pretty sure it's going to be in the bottom right. Huh, it looks like my key up events are interrupting my animations. I'm about to die. I'm a big dummy. You know what? I was going to go edit the code. That's something I used to do all the time when I was doing streaming for this game, but I really shouldn't do it right now. Just keep swimming. Those little dead ends might be a bug in my level generator. Or maybe I just decided not to have it remove dead end hallways for this level. Oh, you know what? Why am I wearing a tactical vest when it could be laser-proof? And let's wear some work gloves, which are going to be better. Yeah, see, that's way better for me. Because if they hit me on the torso, which is the biggest target, they're just going to do no damage. Enemies are pretty good at hunting you down. So I haven't found the exit yet, which is surprising. It's making me a little suspicious. I'm very suspicious. I'm going to cheat. There's a cheat code. Let's just see the whole map. Okay, yep. There is an exit. It does exist. It's right over here. Having escaped the Velociraptor pen with your life, this cold, wet, artificial cave seems like a welcome change until you see the word stenciled on the walls. Mecha Piranha Habitat. Uh-oh. There's another one where I'm just going to kind of beeline for the exit. So I'm going to say the exit's going to be near the lower left. I've already forgotten what that bug was that I was going to fix. Oh, right, the animation key up thing. This big laser gun is just, you know, everyone dies immediately, pretty much, which maybe is not the most fun. Kind of depends on your point of view, I think. I think this little guy deserves a giant laser gun with which he can kill everyone. Rewards you for learning the game and you know, finding out how to find the good stuff, because those big laser guns really only appear in those special rooms, which you only see if you really explore. There's my exit. All right. At last, you are face to face with your mad tormentor, Dr. Hallervorden. He holds a massive, deadly-looking laser weapon, and he barks a bitter laugh as he notices you enter the room. You thought it would be so easy. Excuse me, let me do the accent right. You thought it would be so easy, he grumbles hoarsely. Time to die!
Okay. Dr. Hallervorden, the mad doctor himself, dressed in a blood-stained lab coat, his wild, staring eyes track your every move. Der Hallerzapper is a pretty serious piece of equipment. Let's put on our tactical vest. That's pretty much as good as it gets. I'm gonna hide behind this column, take a health potion, wait for him to show up. Maybe I should just shoot him a little bit, just for fun. Just gonna sit here and pop health potions all day long. Actually, what are his resistances? I'm not gonna do very well against him with this. He's only wearing a lab coat. So it's kind of weird that I'm not doing that much damage to him. But maybe I should just get up close and personal and do like a shock baton. Ooh, that's a lot of damage.
What I really want to do is let him get fatigued. Oh, there we go. The taser. Taser's where it's at. I'm like, tase, heal. Tase, heal. Now he's fatigued. I can really go to town. I only have 5 health boosts left, so this better work soon. He's dead. I got him. My inventory won't fit a Der Haller zapper, but I don't need it because I won. You win! I definitely didn't die at all that whole time. Thank you for watching. This has been Dr. Hallervorden. Now you know the secrets of the Mad Doctor's laboratory.